Thanks for joining us on the Torrens Uni Cup Wrap. My name's Zach Milbank, and with me today is SANFL High Performance Manager Brenton Phillips. How are you, Sticko?
Very well, thanks, Zach.
Good to hear. Thought we'd naturally chat about the big one this weekend on Saturday. Of course, it's the Under-16s Torrens Uni Cup Grand Final. Glenelg playing Woodville West Torrens. We've got a beauty on our hands, Sticko. It's Glenelg undefeated at going against Woodville West Torrens. We've only lost the one game, so it's going to be a cracker.
It will be. It's a repeat of last year's. Both these teams went into the grand final of this competition last year, so it's a repeat effort. Glenelg got the biscuits last time, so I'm sure that Darren Hams and his Eagles counterparts down there will be looking to reverse the trend there.
Of course, starting at 2:10 p.m. at Football Park on Saturday afternoon. Entry is free, so make sure you get along and have a look at what should be a very entertaining contest. Who's going to win, Sticks?
Oh, look, it'll be, as you said, an enthralling contest. There's some real talent in both teams. So you probably lean towards Glenelg with the season that they have had, and saying that, so too as the Eagles. I've seen them a number of times, and they've got a fairly good group of players coming through there also. So I'm looking forward to it. It really gives us a good indicator of how strong our competition is with the standard of the games. We saw our semi-finals last Thursday night, and that was really good, albeit it was a very dewy occasion down the heavy dew come into Footy Park on Thursday night, and it became a pretty much a slippery contest, and it was very body-on-body contest. So barring that, it was really good to see four teams go at it.
And, of course, Glenelg won the first of those semi-finals, about 10-goal winners against Central District, and then the Eagles really made to work quite hard by Sturt in the other semi.
Yeah, look, that particular semi was Sturt. I thought they were coming at certain stages, and it only needed one or two more goals by the Sturt boys, and it would have really thrown the cat amongst the pigeons. Whilst the other game was a 10-goal win to Glenelg, they didn't have it all on their terms. I thought Central's really held in strongly. It was one of those interesting games where they just didn't seem to have the run of the game at any point in time. You know, every 50-50 decision just didn't seem to go with the boys from out north. So, but in saying that, Glenelg were very, very good. And Luke Edwards, an extremely good footballer down there, so he's come on nicely.
Glad you mentioned Luke. I was going to chat about that as our next item to discuss. Obviously, the release this week of the McDonald's SA Under 18 squad to contest the 2017 AFL National Championships. And of course, Luke is a member of that side and one of a couple of father sons in the initial squad. Of course, Luke being the son of Tyson Edwards, younger brother of Jackson Edwards, who is out at the Bays. And the other one we refer to is Mitchell Mead, the son of Darren Mead.
Yeah, look, they're, both them lads will go into our under-16 state squads, and that that competition's run up on the Gold Coast in the first week of the July school holidays. Have a leading game against WA over in Perth, so that's a really good leading game. And then we go up there and finish off with a couple of games up there. Look, the squad, the initial squad that I've seen that's come across my desk looks really promising. It's got some nice size about it. So we're looking to have a pretty strong side again. And Coach Darryl Hart, hopefully he'll get the best out of them, and hopefully we can come away with the chocolates.
And, of course, with Luke Edwards, just tell us a little bit more about him. Is he built similar to Jackson and play a similar way?
Yeah, look, my understanding is Luke's still a 15-year-old, so he's got a couple of years in the under-16 comp. Yeah, very similar to Jackson. Yeah, big, strong lad. Takes a really good contested mark, got fantastic game awareness, and through traffic's really good, sets up play nicely. So, yeah, he'll be a strong contender for that state side.
And Mitchell Mead, does he resemble that of his father, the Port Adelaide champion centre-half back?
Yeah, not really in terms of playing key positions, a little bit smaller at this point in time, but he's a strong inside midfielder, that's the way I describe him. Works really hard up both ends of the ground, gets lots of balls through the middle of the ground, and enables us to go forward and propels his teams forward. So, yeah, he's a real talent too, so we look forward to both them.
We do indeed, Sticks. Well, thank you very much for joining us on the Torrens Uni Cup Wrap. We look forward to catching up with you again next week.
Thanks, Zach.